stories about witches and wizards have been with us from way back in history, and they're now favourites in movies and TV shows.
Who killed the witch of the East? Was it you?
No. No, it was an accident. I didn't mean to kill anybody.
I'll get you, my pretty. And your little dog, too.
Pedigree. Perogee.
Oh, Charlie! That's better than a tug.
All right, no, okay. If we're gonna have it, let's have it all.
In 300 years, right down to the day, now the witch is back, and there's hell to pay.
I'm a wizard, that's my business.
The land is cursed.
I'll see you fade into nothing!
Find him, we can end this.
I say we jump now!
But now let's welcome a real life witch and author, Lucy Cavendish. Lucy, I'm not insulting you when I call you a witch. That's what you describe yourself as. So,
yes.
So what does that mean? Did you arrive here today on a broomstick, some eye of newt for breakfast?
No. The word itself is very old. It's Old Anglo-Saxon, and the word means two things. It means to bend and to shape, and it also means wise. So what we're trying to do is to work with energy in ways that are wise. It doesn't always quite work that way. We've got to do our best.
But how does someone know they're a witch?
Yeah, look, it's a really good question. I think some people know because their families have a heritage. My family certainly doesn't. I come from a very sort of Aussie, suburban, beachy family, and you know, it's all meat pies and football. And they had this odd little kid living in it who was seeing things and feeling things.
So that was when you knew.
I didn't call myself a witch at that stage. I just thought I was really weird. And
teenager, really?
Well, no, actually, it was a little different to that because I would sit in, you know, you sit in your schoolyard and you sit in a circle with all your friends and everyone's going, boyfriends, pimples, and you're going, weird things at night. It was really very different for me.
No, that sounded like my teenhood.
Yeah, well, there's... not those kind of weird things, but... yeah.
So why do you think people are still scared of witches? We've got a lovely young producer here, Celestina, who was meeting you today, and before she met
and
you...
And who was nervous.
She was scared.
Yeah.
And but I said, don't be scared because you're a beautiful white witch.
Well, look, but you see, I wouldn't call myself a white witch either because that's a little bit like saying you're a good policeman or you're a nice teacher. Do you see what I mean?
And it's... also it's racist.
That's Cell meeting you at the front door of Channel 10 there, I think.
Yeah. She was like, should I let her in? Look, to me... Yes, people are frightened because there are so many stereotypes out there. There's this notion that you will do things against people's will, and I think that is one of the primary causes.
So can you do spells?
Yes, you do work spells. That's a very important part of
what we do. So practically, how does that work, that bending and changing things? How do you actually... What's your day-to-day work? You wake
up
in the morning...
What we need to do before you can really... Look, you can call yourself a witch at any stage, but you do go through traditionally a year and a day of training. Right. And that takes you through each of the lunar cycles and through the whole solar cycle. And once you've kind of got that experience, you can really begin to work. And when we cast spells, we tend to work with natural energies. And there's a real law, which is you never cast against someone's will. You just do not do that.
Because we cast spells. Like any of my girlfriends, their husband dumps them for a younger woman. We have a ritual where we burn his underpants and his favourite magazines and things. And we kind of do a sort of girly bonding.
But underneath, something really powerful is taking place. Mm-hmm. And, you know, burning is a true clearing.
Lucy, we've got Angie Bowie on later in the show, and you say that musicians like David Bowie have taken a lot of their inspiration from the occult, right?
That's right. Mm. For example, Hunky Dory, which was an incredible album, and I've been listening to it again a lot lately, has a song on it called Quicksand. Mm. And the first two lines of it are about the Golden Dawn, which was an occult society in London in the late 1800s. And the second line is about Aleister Crowley, who was an immensely powerful magician in the late 1800s. And it's woven all throughout his work, particularly in that 70s period. Yeah.
TV and movie producers love the very old story of Merlin.
Oh. Yeah.
Did such a character exist?
It's something that I go into in the book because it's something I'm really curious about. And Merlin, the word actually means hawk or head druid. Mm. So the word has a slightly different meaning. So I believe that archetype of Merlin emerged from a whole series of real-life wizards.
Do you have a cat? Can I just ask you?
You know, I'm such a disappointing
I've got
witch.
Two cats.
I'm a downer of a witch because I do not have a black cat. I have four dogs who are like my wolves. So, and I certainly don't set them on people in case they get a little freaked out by me saying that. But I have four dogs. I think working with animals and familiars and that kind of energy is really important. Anyone who has a lot of animals around has a lot of instinctual energy.
Mm. And can I just say, all through history, all interesting women were demonised as witches. We would all have been burned at the stake just for having an opinion.
Absolutely.
And being independent.
Yeah, and that word, I think reclaiming it is important because it's not an insult, it's not a term of disgust. Mm. It's actually a powerful word. And most of us, men are witches too, most of us
have
this innate power.
I'm sure Joe has got a beautiful wand.
Are you sure? Give your wand to yourself.
Magic, darling.
It's a wand.
It works magic, don't you worry about that. Do you want to have a spell cast on you?
Lucy Cavendish has published a fascinating book on the history of witches and wizards. It is available at Big W and all bookstores. Please, let's thank Lucy now.